In this video, we're gonna be talking about my top five favorite philodendrons. Yes, it's another top five favorite, okay? So let's just go. If we're just first meeting, my name is Sharina, and thank you so much for clicking on this video today. I hope you're having an amazing day, okay? So the very first one, girl, I am so obsessed with this one. Ladies and gentlemen, will you take a look at my beautiful philodendron Brandtianum? Now, will you take a look at how gorgeous this is? I love the indentations. I love the silver sheen. I love the heart shape. I love absolutely everything about this plant. I have not stopped staring at it ever since I got it. I haven't had this for very long. I've only had this for a couple of weeks. I actually did a live unboxing of this plant. Don't watch it, but this has just been a favorite of mine ever since I got it, basically. So I've been looking for this, I've been checking back every day, and it's just, I'm just so happy I ordered from them, because I've mentioned before, every time I order plants, I get really scared. Like, I don't know how they'll turn out, right? So when we order plants, you just gotta keep in mind, you gotta take it with a grain of salt. I don't even know what that saying means, to be honest, but people say it, so whatever. This actually came with 11 leaves. Some of them are actually a really good size, and there's two new growths right here. So let me share that with you. There's one right back there and another one right there. And these philodendrons I'm actually gonna be sharing with you, I think, are also fast growers. They're beautiful, they grow really fast, and they've been pretty easy. Also, I've paired it with a silver pot to kind of give it that monochromatic look, like silver on silver. I think it looks really cool. I don't know, tell me what you think. I have it placed right over here in my office, right by a south window, so she is getting a lot of light. I want this Brandy to have her best life ever, so I'm gonna give her the best care, the best light, the best water, which is tap. So, okay, so the next one, hands down, again, one of my favorite philodendrons. If you're drinking, take some shots every time I say favorite. Ladies and gentlemen, please let me introduce you to the beautiful philodendron Camposportoanum. I hope I said that correctly, but oh my goodness, look how beautiful these leaves are. I love that they're velvety, they're really delicate. The new leaves, when they unfurl, they're, again, a completely different color. This one is a much lighter sheen with little hints of pink, little hints of bronze, kind of like purplish in there, but you gotta look really hard. Take a look at this one right over here. I love this one so much. The leaf shape is just so unique, right? Like, it's like, I don't know, what is this, like ovaries? But it's kind of shaped like that rabbit that you get on Easter, that little bunny candy, or shaped like a bunny with these little ears. It's so cute, so adorable. Now, I got this one for free, $99, at a plant swap about a couple of months ago, back in the day when we would go outside and, you know, see people. This one is a little bit damaged, the larger leaf. I don't even care, because I know that it was gonna grow out and have a lot better leaves like this, and it's definitely been growing. It's not growing as fast as I would like, you know, as far as a philodendron goes, but it's okay. I am still really happy with it. When I was looking up the care for this guy, man, sometimes Google will scare you with like their care tips. It said it needed filtered light, which I'm not even sure exactly what that means, the highest soil, which I understand, because of course you do want to give your plants really good soil, the best kind of water, probably distilled water. To be honest, I'm just caring for it exactly how I would care for my other philodendrons. With watering, I don't wait till this is 100% fully dry, because in my experience, when I have plants that kind of have the velvety leaves like this, I don't want to wait till they're completely dried out, because it's a bit different, it's a bit textured. So wait till it's maybe 70% dry and then I water it. What is that chocolate called? Okay, I'm gonna figure it out. Maybe I'll insert a picture of what that is called here. Hi, okay, so the next one is actually out in my living room, so we're gonna go over there and look at this next favorite philodendron of mine. So let's go. So here we are, welcome to my living room. Let me take you to the next plant here. Oh, hello. So this next favorite philodendron is my beautiful Philodendron Pastazanum. Now, will you just take a look at how massive this one is? This one has been growing so well. Actually, it would do a lot better if I had more lighting right up there, because right now it's getting medium light. And as you can see, that part is stretching over here to my south window, trying to get much more light, which tells me that this is not enough for him. It is so big, it's just kind of hard to find the best spot for it, but let me get you up close. Now here we are going up close. I love everything about this plant. Let me show you a comparison with my hand. Look how huge that is. I love the indentations, I love the veins, I love the huge heart shaped. That's the newest leaf. It is just massive, and I mean, it's just doing so well. I don't know, is that a gallon pot? I don't know, but here is another new growth that's growing right back there. This one actually grows pretty fast also. I actually want to turn this around to show you a comparison to my face, just to show you how huge this is. I am giving you a comparison to my face, to my head, to my torso. Look how ginormous this is. I got this actually at a plant swap, I think late last year, and it wasn't a trade, okay? The person that was trading this with us was actually selling it, I think, for $30, which is a good deal because it was already huge. It was massive. So that's kind of one of the problems when you have large plants, it's just finding a spot for them. I'm having a little bit of a trouble with this one because it has to be in the corner, because this is the only space that I can think of that can hold this size. And that's just kind of a thing that we go through with plants. They're gonna grow, you're gonna have to move them around. I think it's just part of the fun of being a plant mom. Let's go back to the office. Hold on, coffee break. The very next one, I'm gonna be honest with you, okay? This one, I hated when I first got it. It was in a 4-inch pot. It was so long. It was all wobbly. The growing pattern was just irritating because it wasn't growing out in a balanced shape. It was just all over the place. Okay, so let me just show you. Right now, I love it because I repotted it, so it's been a little bit, you know, more balanced since I repotted it, and that is my beautiful philodendron. Ooh. Ring of Fire. I love the variegation on this one. As you can see, it's got hints of peach and white and little speckles. I love, love, love the shape of this. Definitely a statement plant. This is beautiful on like a corner or on a wall that's just blank, and the only thing that you're seeing is this plant because of how unique these leaves are. Now, when they open up, the new leaves are actually much more orangish, peach, and then later on, like I had one that actually was, I think this is actually the new leaf. When this opened up, this was more peach and orangish, and it's just since turned more green. Maybe I'm not giving it enough light, but it's actually right by a south window, so that's a lot of light. This one actually has a really good spot in my living room. It's right out there. Here's a new leaf that's coming out. I gotta say though that this plant is so thirsty. Before it was in a 4-inch pot, and now it's more of a 6-inch. It's still thirsty. I thought it was because I had it in a really small pot, but she's just, that's just how she is, okay? She is just a thirsty little plant, but I am loving it. A really beautiful statement plant, really huge right now, a fast grower. Love the variegation, love the speckles. I love everything about this one. Okay, next favorite philodendron, no stranger to my bijos. You've seen this one before. I talk about this one, I think, all the time because it is so gorgeous. It's my beautiful philodendron majesty with its beautiful dark leaves. I love the shape of these leaves. I cannot get over how beautiful and how dark it is. Look at that. Look at these other leaves too. They are just so beautiful. I love the stem and I love how dark it is. I actually have a couple of these now since I just recently potted up this one that I've been propagating. The mother plant grows so fast, okay? And I feel like each time I cut it, the new leaves that grow out of it is actually a lot darker. Let me show you the new ones that I recently cut from it that I'm propagating. So this is another new philodendron majesty cutting that I just cut literally like yesterday. And look, they're darker. This one is more of a burgundy color. Look how beautiful that is. But this one, it is it is just fully black. The cool thing about it is when they kind of like bleed, I don't know how else to call it, because what comes out is like burgundy or reddish. Super interesting. So this is another cutting that I've made. I can't wait to see if my new growth from the mother plant is gonna be even darker. Like how much more darker can you get? It is just so beautiful. Now this one, I've mentioned this before, really, really easy to take care of. I've got this in a lot of light, grows so fast, water when 100% dry. One of my easiest and one of my most favorites. I'm gonna say it again. I cannot wait to have a lot of just black leafed plants in my household. That's just like a goal and a dream of mine. And this is just like the start of it, right? If you missed any other videos, I'm gonna make sure to link them right here on the screen or somewhere below. I appreciate you. Thank you so much for being here. Give me a like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.